name Whitechapel is a reference to the Jack the Ripper, the place of the murders.
Yes, you are. That's, I don't know, when we started the band, we wanted a name that was, like, kind of short and to the point, but at the same time it had, like, kind of a dark and ominous, you know, like, presence to it, because that's, you know, how our music is. And a couple of guys were watching that movie, From Hell, with, I think it has, like, Johnny Depp in it or whatever. It's about Jack the Ripper. And somebody was just like, how about Whitechapel? And we were like, that's cool. You know, it has a nice ring to it. The background of it's cool, so why not? So it just kind of stuck.
Have you done a tour whilst you're in London? The Jack the Ripper tour?
Not yet, but I think we're actually going to do that tomorrow. So it should be pretty cool.
Yeah, that'd be amazing. So tell me about the band. How did you come together?
Well, we all come from relatively the same city, except for our drummer, Kevin. He lives about 2 hours away from the rest of us. And we all kind of came together because we were all in different local bands, and we all knew each other through playing with each other's bands and stuff, you know, different local shows and stuff. So we all knew, you know, everyone's musical capabilities and stuff like that. And the band was started with Ben, Phil, and our old guitarist, Brandon. And they, you know, started this idea for this band. They were in this band that sounded kind of like Between the Buried and Me. It was like kind of tech metal stuff or whatever. And they wanted to do something a little less complicated and a lot heavier, like, you know, lower tuned and stuff like that. So they started this band. They didn't have a name for it. They were just like, you know, writing riffs and stuff like that. And I was friends with Phil, and Phil showed me some of the stuff, and I was just blown away. I was like, man, this stuff's awesome. I was like, this is what I wish my band sounded like, you know. And he was like, well, you know, we should get together and jam sometime.
What influenced the decision to keep, to have three guitarists rather than the usual two? Was it to add a bit more technical side, or was it to just get a heavier sound?
To be honest, the real reason why we started out with three guitar players was because there were three guitarists interested in the position, and we were all friends, so it was kind of hard to tell one of them that they couldn't be in the band, you know? So we were like, oh, well, we had heard of other bands doing three guitars before, so we were like, you know, why not? Let's try it. So we tried at that first practice, and, you know, from the get-go, it was pretty muddy and stuff. We didn't really know how to control the three guitars, but as we went along in our career and we've learned, especially with, like, you know, This Is Exile and the new album and stuff, we've, you know, learned how to actually write with three guitars and you know, to really, like, you know, hone the aspects of, you know, having three guitars and stuff like that. So
I'm interested how you would define your music, because a guy at a gig last night said, and I thought it was the best description, because we were saying, what box would you put them in? And he said, the thinking man's deathcore, which I quite liked.
Yeah,
how
yeah.
would you describe yourself?
Yeah, I've actually heard that before.
Have you?
Yeah, I did an interview yesterday, and some guy was like, I like you guys because, like, you know, he was like, you know, I don't know how you feel about it, but I would definitely call you deathcore, but it's not like the typical deathcore. He was like, you know, it's like, I don't know, it has like more thought and feeling put into it and stuff like that.
He stole that from us.
Oh, okay.
He made my questions.
But you know, I don't really care, like, you know, what people want to call us. Like, we're just playing metal. That's, you know, we just consider ourselves a metal band. You know, we have all kinds of, you know, influences, from death metal to, you know, regular, just like old school heavy metal to, you know, progressive metal like Meshuggah and stuff like that. So you know, we just try to cover the entire ground, and I think just because we play blast beats and breakdowns doesn't really make us, you know, quote-unquote deathcore or whatever. You know, I'm not going to knock somebody out for them calling us deathcore, but
good, because I was worried there.
Yeah. You know, a lot of bands seem to, like, take offense from it or something. It's like, I don't know, it's almost like being called new metal or something like that, you know, but to me, personally, you know, and for the rest of the band, we don't really care what we're called, just as long as the people, you know, like our music and stuff, so.
And how do you describe the characters within the band? What you like of people?
Honestly, a lot of people, especially, like, some bands and stuff, have always told us, they're just like, man, we're like, kind of scared of you guys. Like, because of your music, we always thought you guys were, like, assholes and stuff like that. And, you know, they're just like, we're scared to tour with you or whatever. And what's funny is that it's, like, the exact opposite. Like, you know, whoever we are, whatever we do on stage is completely different from off stage. We're just a bunch of goofballs, and we like to have fun just like anybody else, so.
So can we expect possibly a DVD to get to know you more?
Definitely. We do plan on doing a DVD. You know, we've been watching a lot of different live band DVDs, like especially the new Meshuggah one that came out. And, you know, we're just trying to get an idea of how exactly we want to construct it and how, you know, we want to make it. We really like the Black Dahlia Murder DVD that came out last year. That was a really awesome band DVD.
So can we get lots of nakedness from you then?
I don't know. Dahlia Murder, love that. I don't know about nakedness, but... I don't know. I like it when you know, I like seeing the serious side of a band, but I like seeing the fun side too. So we'll probably, you know, try to incorporate, you know, all kinds of different aspects.
How have you been received on tour with Trivium and Chimaira? Because you have got a very heavy sound.
Mm-hmm. It's been good. Like I told another interview, It's kind of like the best of both worlds because I feel like Chimaira's fan base leans towards us a little bit more because they're definitely a lot more like us. It's a way heavier sound. You know, they don't have really, you know, very many clean vocals at all. It's, you know, mainly just screaming and stuff, which is, you know, what we're all about. And, you know, Trivium's kind of on the other end. You know, they have their heavier parts, but they have a lot more, like, clean singing and melodic stuff, so... the people who are there to see Trivium because of like all the melody and the singing and stuff aren't really into us, but you know, the people that are there to see Chimaira and Trivium for their heavier aspects, you know, they're really receiving us well and stuff. So I feel like it's definitely good for us to kind of you know, tour with these more mainstream bands who have bigger fan bases and stuff, because it's only going to help us in the long run.
Is that what influenced you to record and use the producer Jason Sukoff?
Yeah, definitely. You know, both of those bands have recorded albums with Sukoff, and, you know, both of the albums that they have done, you know, sound great. And, you know, along with a lot of other bands, you know, really influenced our decision, like Black Dahlia Murder, they've recorded two albums with them, and Barrier Dead, they've recorded two albums with them, and, you know, we love all of those albums as well. So it was only natural. We wanted somebody that would really capture... you know, Whitechapel's true sound. Like, on Exile, it was a great mix, it was great music, don't get me wrong, but I think this new album's definitely a very, you know, big step forward in the career of Whitechapel as far as our sound progressing and stuff.
So it's going to be an exciting new album.
Yeah, definitely. I love it. I think it's great. I love the music, I love the production, and I think I'm really excited to get it out there.
Can you give us any secret exclusives? Like, for example, possibly what it might be called?
Yeah, I can tell people that now. The name of the album is going to be A New Era of Corruption, which if you've listened to Exile, you know that there's a line in the song Possession that says, "Man will inspire the works of a new era of corruption." And we decided to name it that because we wanted to bring a little bit of a flavor from This Is Exile into the new album so that our older fans could kind of have something to like latch on to and stuff, you know. And as well, I feel like the name reflects, you know, the our music and this whole new genre of deathcore, extreme new music or whatever. I feel like it kind of reflects, the name reflects that as, you know, us and bands like Job for a Cowboy and Suicide Silence are like this new era of extreme music that's, you know, pushing forward.